also thank all the staffs of Department of CSC for their continuous support and motivation for doing this type of activities. So from FTP this thing, so this webinar, what exactly you can take away? There is FTP takeaways. So what and all I'm going to cover in next two sessions, that is this session and tomorrow sessions. So first thing is, so LaTeX setup. So that is, I'm going to just start from seeing initial step for a beginner, how exactly you can set up your LaTeX environment and on your device, so and work with LaTeX, how to start with LaTeX as a beginner, how to use LaTeX templates. So that is, you will be having a different template for report writing, for thesis, and for paper writing and all. So how to work, how to understand the template, and how to work with this thing. And lastly, how to work with the reference sections. So that is, when we are going with our any reporting, or if you are going with any of your thesis writing means, so reference is the main this thing. So I'm going to just show you how exactly you can simplify in very without any complexity, you can generate your bibliography. So all this thing, so you're going to just learn in these two sessions. So I'll be giving a brief introduction. So I hope definitely after this session, so you'll be able to confidently, you'll be able to start your research documentation, whether it may be paper or it may be your thesis. So both you can take up with confidence, and you can come out with a beautiful documentation using LaTeX. So coming to the agendas of today's this thing, so it's already shared in your group. So how exactly, where exactly we have to begin, and why we have to go for LaTeX, what are the fundamentals, working operations in LaTeX. So all this thing I'm going to just deal with today's session. Coming to the tomorrow session, so I'll be taking only on thesis bibliography, that is how exactly, so we can, as an individual without knowing much about LaTeX also, how exactly you can draft your thesis using LaTeX. So that is what the tomorrow session. And I'm going to share my experience of thesis drafting. Since my thesis was drafted in LaTeX, so it was not a direct this thing. So I'll be just sharing some information. So it may be helpful for you people to decide whether you have to go for LaTeX or you should not go for LaTeX. So if so, when you can go for LaTeX and when you should not go for LaTeX. So I'll be just sharing my experience, and I'll be sharing some tips for you, all the participants. So using that particular tips, you can definitely start documentation using LaTeX confidently. So thank you all for joining the session. So now let's begin the session with this end of presentation. So there is no much presentation. So as next we are having only the, since it is hands-on activity, I thought of coming with full some practical aspects. So coming to this thing, so agenda, as I told, so why LaTeX? So we are going to just deal first like why we are going for LaTeX. Next, we are going to check how exactly you can set up LaTeX environment in your desktop or computer. Next, I'm going to show some example, basic example, how exactly you can start with LaTeX. Then I'm going to show you like how exactly you can work with templates. So here I have taken a IEEE paper templates, and I'll be just showing one simple documentation, how exactly you can go for report documentation. So coming to why LaTeX, so before going to the LaTeX, so if you are a beginner or you're about to start with LaTeX, so you may be having question like why LaTeX. So when you are having MS Office, so you can do all document very easily or this thing, but what is the specialty of LaTeX? So once you understand, then only you can motivate yourself, and you can put your effort in documentation using LaTeX. So I will just share some my own documentation which has done in LaTeX. So why LaTeX? So these are the documentation I am having. just a minute. So you can just check what and all options I am having in the LaTeX. So first thing is, so you can see this is my PhD thesis, which has been awarded in 2018, which was done in LaTeX. So you can see the how exactly the documentation is. So you can observe the font. So I'll be just zooming that one. You can observe the font, what you are getting in LaTeX. So this will motivate you to take up your thesis to do in LaTeX. So since thesis will be a hard work of our 4 to 5 years of work, and we should have a documentation, means we should document it very neatly, and we should have a perfect this thing. So you can see how exactly this documentation has been done. So the entire thesis has been drafted in LaTeX. So on left side, you can see once if I compile my thesis in LaTeX, you can see acknowledgements. So if I go for some chapters, okay, you can see introductions, overview. Next, if I go for chapter 2, I can directly navigate to this chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 3, section 1, 3.1. All this thing one, I have not done any separate configuration for this one. So just while doing in LaTeX documentation, while typing this, all this text, so I just use some LaTeX tags, and without any much coding or without any doing of much of effort, so I have got this particular thing features. So apart from this, so you can just see reference management. So I was telling that tomorrow you are going to have that reference management. You can see chapter 1 introduction. So here I have not configured, like I have not set like as in MS Office. So introduction should be 18, chapter should be 16, content should be 12. So like that, I have not done any own this thing. I have just used some tags. So that tags will take care of everything. So the LaTeX is like one major difference in LaTeX and Word is in Word, what you type, you will get the same thing. So that is the formatting, the print layout will be preserved. But in LaTeX, so it is not like that. So you'll be not able to see the format till you deploy, till you create your LaTeX file. Everything will be taken care by LaTeX. Only thing is you have to use the proper tags, and you have to use proper, means you have to just draft your statement, that's all. So remaining formatting, all option will be taken care by the LaTeX. So no need to worry about not even one particular formatting, including this numbering also. So if you go for this thing means, so you can see table of list of figures, list of tables, and mainly contents. So not even one Word I have edited in content. So everything will be auto-generated. Even you can do this one in Word, but with little bit more complex. But yeah, you can see you'll be getting your documentation as you are having in the your textbook. So you might have seen some textbook, how exactly the textbooks will be. So like that, you will be getting a font, not even one single this thing description you will be having with respect to the formatting or with respect to any content this thing. So all page number, everything will be automatically generated. So no extra effort should be made by the user to do all this option. So in Word, the problem is, so if you add some 1-2 paragraph to this overview, this particular page number will be changed. So then you have to come to manually and you have to update. So if you are not using any advanced Word option, then you have to do all this thing manually. But in LaTeX, it is not so. So everything will be auto-generated. And you can see here, if you want to cross-verify in Word, it may be difficult to cross-verify. But you can see now, if I want to go to 1.3, current WSN status. So if I want to go for 1.3, so I will just click on this page number. You can see 5, it is showing a hyperlink. So if I just click, I'll be directing to my 1.5. So 1.3. So here I can see my section. So I can verify, cross verify this one, and that is with respect to the section, this thing, chapter number. So, and you can see here in section 1.2 means in thesis, many time you may be, you have to do the back referencing, means you have to give a related or valid proof or something, you have to back reference to the previous chapter, or you have to back reference to the previous section. So that is very easy in LaTeX. So in section 1.2, I have just given. So if I just click 1.2, so I'll be navigating to 1.2. So the benefit of this thing is now all the universities are doing online evaluation. So your thesis will go online. So that time it will be very helpful for the reviewer to just refer all these details. So if I just click 1.2.1, so it will come to this particular section. So that cross referencing, back referencing are very much effective and very much important for the research documentation, and that is very easy in the LaTeX. So next, coming to the reference. So you can see here 1.2.1. So for this, I have used reference 1. So now I'll just click this reference 1. So you can see, so I can see like which particular paper I have referred for that topic, which was there in 1.2.1. And the same thing will appear in this one also, 1.21. That is, so again, I have to navigate to the previous section, that is 1.2.1. So if I want to navigate to this one, so you have to just click this one. So I'll be going for 1.2.1. So this will be very effective for research documentation, and it will be very easy when you do all this thing in the LaTeX. So in fact, if you are having any figures, so for example, so if we are referred for any figure 1 or figure 2, if you have given me, so for that also you can give the references. So you can see figure 1 represent, but here there is no figure 1, but if I click on this one, so I'll be navigating to the figure 1.1. So this is the beauty of LaTeX, that referencing will become very easy, and you can see the alignments, you can see the font clarity, what you are having. So all this thing, so you'll be getting only with the LaTeX documentation. So this is how you have to go with LaTeX. And one more important this thing is, so you will be working in your different tools. For coding, you may be using different tools, you may be having your algorithms, or you may be having your results. So for getting that result, it is very easy in LaTeX. Like, so I'll just show one of my this thing. So it was executed and got in this thing, MATLAB. The thing, graphs and all has been generated in MATLAB versions. So you can see the clarity of this result section. So this is directly exported by MATLAB. So that is, so in MATLAB, so you can export the figure in one particular format, which is called as EPS format. And you can see the points. So every individual points, every individual scales, what and all you're having. So you can you view this one, and the clarity will be super. So this is what you can get whenever you're doing in the LaTeX. So this is a benefit. You can directly, other than JPEG, PNG, you can just import the EPS format. So other than EPS, you are having n number of formats, so which is available in LaTeX. So you can just directly, without any additional this thing, you can just refer that one. So no need to convert that one to JPEG or PNG. So you can directly import that one, and the clarity will be, so full HiFi clarity you will be having. And one more is, so if you have any particular algorithms, so you might have written any algorithms. So you can, if you have observed textbooks and all, you can see how the algorithms will be. If you refer data structures or any other this thing, so the algorithm representation is different in textbook. So you can get that algorithm representation without much configuration, or without much formatting option like Word. So you can easily design an algorithm for your particular research work. So, and you can get your algorithm, so, and it will look more effective, and it will be more useful whenever you're having your all research documentation. So this is with respect to the thesis. And apart from thesis, so I have one lab manual which was done in LaTeX. So the features of this doing so is, you can see the lab manual. So the same thing, if you want to do in Word, means it will be very difficult. So this is one machine learning lab manual. So where you can see here, 20 to 21 lines of programs are there. This is not hard coded. So just what and all program you will be having in .py extension or .c extension or .java extension, you can just import that one to LaTeX. Remaining everything LaTeX will take care. So that is highlighting the keywords and highlighting the user defined functions. And if there is any new line character, giving that new line character symbol, ensuring the line numbers for the program. So everything will be taken care by LaTeX. So this is the beauty of LaTeX. So if you want to include any piece of source code for your research documentation, so this will be the best way of including the your piece of program or your coding snippet into the research documentation. So that is what the benefit of doing your research documentation in LaTeX. Next, apart from that, so don't think that only computer science related can be done in LaTeX. So I have one, since we have participants from all this thing, so I've taken all what and all branches are there, biology, chemistry, geography, everything, there is an option for LaTeX. So now you are seeing this, our country map, India map you are seeing. So this is not any image which is taken from Google or which is not image created and drawn this thing. The complete image, what you are going to see, including the states and its capital and including the state border. So everything has been done in LaTeX. So that is without importing any piece of map, any piece of images. So you can even draw our country map using LaTeX. So by giving the coordinates, by giving the proper point, you can just create a map using LaTeX also. And you can see the clarity of that one. So if you see any particular this thing, this clarity you will be getting apart from LaTeX. So if you want this clarity, means you have to go for CorelDRAW. But that is a very tedious job for a faculty, so this thing to sit and draw in CorelDRAW. So LaTeX is one best solution for that one. So you can see, if I zoom, so I can see every individual curve I can see in this options. So every individual curve you can see in LaTeX. So that is the beauty of LaTeX. That is the clarity. And that is the crystal, this thing you will be getting for your documentation whenever you are doing in LaTeX. So you are having all, whichever the fields you are having, in every field, so you can include LaTeX. So, and one more is coming to the chemistry and the biological this thing. If you want to draw any particular cells or any particular this thing, membranes, you can see just without importing any images. So you can see here, so this is one particular lipid this thing structure. So this has been created using LaTeX. So that is for chemistry also you are having an option, for biology also you are having an option. And coming to the network, so if you are having any networking this thing, thesis or this, you can just go for creating all the component network diagram, everything in LaTeX, and you can see the clarity of that, what you are going to get. And apart from that network, so if you want electrical circuit, yes, you can get electrical circuit. So you can see the clarity again here. So all without drawing anything, without using Paint or MS Office, so you can just use some templates, use some tags, and you can get this particular documentation. So all this thing with respect to the this thing, and flowcharts, even flowcharts also you can use, and you can do with your LaTeX. And if you want, so you can have a profile. So you can see my profile, which was designed in LaTeX. You can see the clarity of the word, and you can see the options which are available in LaTeX. So this is the features, or this is the beauty of LaTeX. So that makes people to go and use for the LaTeX documentation. And it is not like licensed version, it is provided under GPL, that is general public license. So it will be available freely, and you can use that one both on Windows machine and Linux machine, and you can work. So that is why we have to go for LaTeX. Next, coming to the installation setup. So now, what and all installation, what and all documentation features I have shown. So if your installation is not proper, so if you have not configured your LaTeX this thing tech file properly or editor properly, means so then you cannot get that that type of this thing documentation. Starting only you will be held up, and you will be lose interest to do your documentation in the LaTeX part. So that is why you have to starting any of your research documentation in LaTeX. So first you should be very clear with your LaTeX environment. So what and all LaTeX environment. So you have to install, and what are the necessary packages you should go for. So one, there are two LaTeX environment. One is MikeTeX, and another one is TeXLite. So you are having two different LaTeX flavor. You can install any two flavor also. But in this session, I am going to share one particular this thing which is very compatible and very user friendly. So that is MikeTeX. So you can see. So in MikeTeX.org, if you go in, so you can just go for the download page, and you can download this MikeTeX image. So basic MikeTeX. This is, since I am using 64-bit machine, so you are going to download 64. If your machine is 32-bit, then you have to download the 32-bit EXE. So both is available, and this is available for your Linux also. That is, you'll be either using your packages or by using your dep packages or apt-get. You can install for your Ubuntu also. Even it is available for your Mac also. So all three versions, so you are having option. So just check with your machine architecture. If it is 32-bit or if it is 64-bit, just download that particular option, that particular exe file. And so your basic installation will be ready. This is MikeTeX. And second software, what I'm going to show is, one is the editor. So we'll just tell what is the feature of this editor in coming this thing. So before that, I will just show where you can get the Technique Center. So Technique Center is the editor. So if you go for this thing, so this is the environment you will be getting here also. Just download the Technique Center, whether it is 32-bit or 64-bit, according to your machine architecture. Download this software and keep it ready. So this is the first step you have to do. So Technique Center and your LaTeX, MikeTeX are the two software which is very much required. So even though this is optional, so I recommend to use this particular Technique Center for efficient documentation. So first, we'll just go with the installation, how exactly you can install this thing. So now you can see I have downloaded two softwares. Basic MikeTeX, so that is 64-bit, and I'm having Technique Center software. This is a editor, and this is your tech maker. So that is, tech is nothing but a markup language, that is a document markup language, and MikeTeX is one version. So one version, one software which is providing your tech. So other than this, you are having tech live also. So next, coming to the editor, Technique Center is one editor. Even though you will be getting some basic editor with MikeTeX, so you are having additional option like Technique Center, you have Tech Studio, you are having Li-Fi. So like that, you will be having a number of editor. But so I recommend this Technique Center very much, because it was very helpful when I did my thesis. So I am having two this software, since I have already installed. So in this one, I have taken a snapshot during the installation. I am sharing that one. So because I need to share some configuration, this thing, if you make some mistake in configuration, then it will be very difficult to start with your LaTeX. So initially you should be very much clear, and you should set up your working environment very clear, that you should not get any error with respect to the installation. So that is what you have to first decide and start doing, start acting when you're if you're a beginner, or even though if you're having any trouble with this thing, definitely this will help you people to set up your LaTeX environment. So just double click on that by basic MikeTeX installer. So you will be getting an option here. So just you can see here, it is a software which is free software provided under GPL license, and just accept here. So I accept this condition. Next, it will ask whether you want to install LaTeX for only one user or all user. So here I have selected installation for only one user. So in your laptop, you can decide whether for all user you want to give or only for one user. Next part is, so you will be having, this is the main, this thing what you have to observe during the installation. Most of the time when we are installing any software, so we'll just do this tapping option, that is click on next. We even bother of reading what is going on. So that is, that mistake should not happen in LaTeX. So if this is the problem, then if you're not aware of this particular window, then you have to go for internet and check what is the solution for the problem which you are facing. So for that purpose only, I'm having detailed screenshot. And in that one, this is the very much important. You can see install MikeTeX to see user GCBLS ITW EMS, next app data, local program, and MikeTeX. So this is the default path that in Windows 10 your LaTeX will go and installed. It will be stored, and you have to remember this path. So I will tell why, what is the need of this path. So you have to remember this path whenever you are doing any installation. So now I know this path, that is, it is in user GCBLS app data, local program, and MikeTeX. So remembering this, it's not like memorizing this one, just take a screenshot and preserve it so that it will be helpful for future configurations. Next, it will ask what is the setting you want to do. Since all Research Scholar will be working in A4, so don't do any changes for this one. Preferred paper is A4, and if any missing packages, so ask me first. So I will just show this installation also. Next. So next, this will install your LaTeX. You can observe the path. So this installation, hardly it may take one, within 5 minutes, it will be installed. And during installation, you can observe. So here you can see, here hyperref one package is there, UTF one package is there. So LaTeX, so if, while installation, if any error or if any extracting of one package is missed, so you'll be not able to start up quickly with your LaTeX. So you have to just carefully you have to install without any errors. So once installation is done, so if you want to check any updates, so you can just enable this one and just go to the next. So it will tell completing the MikeTeX setup, and you can directly close your window. So this is the installation of your MikeTeX. So if you install this one and without any error, so you without any error notification, you have done this step, means then MikeTeX is installed successfully. Next, how to verify that one. So before starting any thing, first you have to verify where exactly you can access that one, how exactly you can access this one. So like MikeTeX, you cannot directly access, you need an editor. So as I told, Technique Center is one editor, but soon after installing your MikeTeX, MikeTeX will give your one basic editor. So that is called as TechWorks. So you can just click on in search. If you just click TechWorks, so you can see you are having an application called TechWorks. So if you just click on this TechWorks, so your tech document will be open. So here you are going to type all your tags, and you are going to just compile your documentation. So this show that installation is complete for your MikeTeX. So next, coming to the second step. So that is coming to the Technique Center installation. So Technique Center also, I have downloaded the software. Just click on this software. Just double click, accept the license. You can see this is also under GPL. Next, it will be installed in C program files. and don't change any of these default settings, and just click on install and launch. Once you launch this thing, first time you will be getting an option like this, that is information about the Technique Center, and it will ask for the configuration. So most of the people, even when initially I started my LaTeX documentation using Technique Center, so I have suffered a lot for doing this configuration. So that is two major configuration comes into picture. So if you are not able to do that configuration, your Technique Center will not work. So like, since Technique Center is a third party editor, you have to tell where exactly your LaTeX has been installed. So for this purpose only, I told you have to make sure in which particular path your LaTeX has been installed. So this is the configuration wizard. So here you can see here, enter the full path of LaTeX directory where the executable file, whether it may be LaTeX or tech or etc., is located. So this path is nothing but, so I'll just show that path. So path setting. So if in my PC, it was in C drive, user, then in user, it was in GTBLS ITW, ESM, next app data, local. So you can see the path, what I'm going. Same, the screenshot, what I have preserved during my LaTeX installation, that is C drive, users, GTBLS, ITW, EMS, app data, local, inside local, it was in program. So you can see inside program, you are having a mic tech, inside mic tech. So you'll be having a tech directory PDF. You can see one more mic tech, bin, 64-bit machine. And here you can see all your exe file, all application, all exe file. So if you want to verify one exe file, means you can see your PDF LaTeX here. So all PDF, you can see here PDF LaTeX document available here. So I'm just zooming that one. PDF. So you can see this highlighted one, PDF LaTeX. So this is what the Technique Center was asking me to check out. So that is enter a full path where you can find your executable files. So this path, so just double click on your address bar. So you'll be getting a path, just copy this path and paste here. So if you click on next, if you didn't get any error, so then your Technique Center configuration is done. So please, you should be very clear, or else it will be very difficult to go with your Technique Center path configuration. So this is very much required. So I have a screenshot for that one also, configuration of the path. So you can just observe that one, path configurations. So first thing, for PostScript and all, it will be asking a optional. For this, no need to set any option, any this thing, paths and all. So this is for distribution. So LaTeX tech file. So you can see I've copied that entire this thing directory, this particular app data, and I have copied here full directory destinations I have copied. So once after copying, it will give a success message stating that finish and you have been configured your LaTeX profile. You should get this successful message, then only you have done your path configuration correctly. So if your path is different, so then it will throw an error. The application LaTeX has not been found in the directory of your tech distribution. Means if your LaTeX is not installed properly, or if you are giving any different option, so if you are giving any different path, so then you will be getting this error. Means so your Technique Center is not ready to work with your LaTeX. So this is what very much important when you're configuring your Technique Center. So that is about the path configuration. And here one more instruction what I wanted to give is, so when you go for user, GSSS, and first time when you check here, You can see the color of app data is different compared to other folders. Means it is a hidden file. So most of the time, so user cannot view this particular file. So for that, what you can do is go for properties and just click on this hidden items. So show hidden items and click apply and OK. So then you will be able to see this app data. So or else you will be not having any access to graphical interface. You have to navigate through your command prompt. So just make sure that enable all the hidden this thing. So that is, you have to make unhide all the folders which is present in this user, particular users. So this is what you have to take care. So that is about one configuration setup. Mic installation, it's over. Then path configuration is done. Next, Technique Center installation and configuration we have done. So next, coming to one more installation. So this is a dynamic installation, which will be very much important whenever you are working with a template. If, for example, if you are working with any templates, if you have taken any templates in IEEE or any other template, means so you'll be having a option called install that one during dynamically. So in fact, I had one question also. So how do I install missing packages in MicTech? So that option is how exactly you can install that missing packages. For example, you can see here geometry.sty. It is showing the required package is this is requirement of geometry.sy. Since in code I have used use package geometry. So for this, the first step is you have to connect it to the internet. So whenever you are having installing the LaTeX or whenever you are working with any template, so please do connect with the internet and just run that particular any particular templates or any package. Your LaTeX itself will suggest this is in requirement of this one. This particular package is missing, and you can just click on install. So for this, now you can see geometry.sty. So if I give install, the missing packages will be installed. So next, similarly, you can see fancyheader.sty is missing. So it will show and it will throw and pop up install, and you can see it will show the installation, like the installation directory, the particular package as being installed. So and here you should you can check here, always show this dialog box before installing the package. So just don't untick this one, because so if you untick this one, there will be a problem, like you cannot know which package is being installed, and sometimes you cannot know that whether the package has been installed or not. So just tick this one so that every time whenever the package is required, so it will throw and pop up, it will give a pop-up message, and using this one you can install the package. And you should be connected to the internet so to get this particular package installed. So that is how you can go for installing the missing packages in your LaTeX. So this is very much important. Sometimes your program, what and all code you have done, everything will be correct, but with the just missing of this particular package, it will show nearly n number of errors. So since today's session we are having a debugging session also, I will take that one with one example also. So this is what the setup you have to do. This is how you have to go for installing the missing packages. And the reason why you are getting these packages is, that is a pop-up is, in MicTech, so I told you to go with the default installation. So you can see here, that is during installation of my basic MicTech. Install missing packages on the fly. So ask me first. So if you just do some other configuration or don't ask me, so in your Technique Center or in your tech work, you will not get that particular option. So just you have to keep this option, ask me first. So there you will be getting a pop-up, and with that help of pop-up message, you can set up your environment. So that is set up your Technique Center, working environment. So packages, that is during template, you have to just giving use packages, some package name you will be giving, connect to internet and just compile So during compilation, that dynamically it will throw an exception, like there is a requirement of the packages, and you can install that particular package dynamically. So that is one particular option. So now this is all about setup, and I have one more option to show in setup before going for the this thing. So one more option after configuring your Technique Center. So you'll be the most common error what you will be getting is, so you can see this Technique Center. Okay, I'll just give before going for the tech work. Anyhow, we have opened a Technique Center. I will just show some options. So it is like your same MS Office this thing only. The controls are so similar. Control S, Control Z, Control W, Control Q. You will be having the same control. Apart from that, you are having some beautiful features here. So I will come to these beautiful features when you are going for execution. So as of now, we need only two options. One is compile and run. So that is how exactly we can compile and view the output. So you can see here, build current file. That is compile here means, so how to build the current file. So just click on this one, build current file. So here you can see the build output, zero errors, zero warnings. So this is, and it has created one page of documentation. So to view this option, so what how exactly I can view means, so next to this you will be having an option called view output, that is F5 if you press means. So you can see the PDF. So here I am having one PDF with some document. So this is how the building option will work. So this is one option, that is compile and view. So you are having one more option, build and view. So you can see here, that is Control Shift F5. So the feature of this one is, so if you just double click this, it will build and it will open the PDF file automatically. So this is with build and view. So this two option, any two options. So you can use any one option whenever you are doing with this, working with Technique Center. So here to building this one, so you have to do one major configuration. That is, this is second configuration, what you are doing in your Technique Center. First one is path setting, that is during the time of installation. And second one is, so defining the output profile. So output profile means now the output is coming in the PDF. So it should be, you have to configure this PDF. So how to do this, that particular is, you can go for build, define output profiles. So you can just go for build, define output profile. And so here just go for viewer option. So in viewer option, so here the first option, only thing you have to configure is the first option is, by default, it will be taking your Adobe Reader. If it is not taken your Adobe Reader EXE file main, so just you have to set that particular path. Means you have to make your Adobe Reader as your default document viewer. So just go for, just if your path is not configured, means just click on this one. Just go for your program files. Just logical drive, C drive, program file, Adobe, inside Adobe Reader. Here you will be having one EXE file. So you can see the red color one, application file. So if you just select this one, so this path will be done. And second, this thing is by default, whenever you are doing, so this will, most of the time, this will be taken automatically. No need to worry about this thing. So your installation, the server will be Acro Viewer. This will be the default installation. So I will just show now default installation, what is the error I will be getting. So if I just give view output, so there is no PDF opened in my this thing, and you can see that I'll be getting one error called unable to open, means so you're not able to open your PDF. Like that you will get one message. So you can see cannot execute the command. So that is file open is not done properly. So this is the major issues that most of them will be getting whenever you are doing your working with your Technique Center. But because of that, so don't leave the working of Technique Center, because so you'll be having a very good option. So in Technique Center, so for this, the solution is the same: build, define output profile in viewer. So since Acro viewer will be your default option, so here you have to just add R20, that is you have to specify the specific version command for your Adobe Reader. So that is, if you are getting Acrobat Reader DC, if you have installed recent updated Adobe Reader, means just add R20 to all the server. If you are using the Adobe Reader of version 9 and below, means so just make this R10 and R10, and click on OK. Then you will be done with the error. There will be no error whenever you are doing so. So this is a very, if you check for Stack Overflow, if you check for any other this thing, this is the most common error that you will be getting in the Technique Center. So now, since my Adobe Reader is updated version, so I'm going to have Acro View R20. Just add this command, R20. If you're having lesser version, you can just add R10. So that is Adobe Reader, the version which is less than 9 and 10. So you have to just mention R10. Okay. So now you can see I will not get that particular error. So I'll be directly opening with my PDF. So this is all about the configuration and setting up your LaTeX environment. So if you are not having the good comfortable environment, means then definitely it will be a very difficult to start with the LaTeX. So whatever the this thing coding may be, even though if you go for HTML, PHP, Python, whatever the coding, so you should be first familiar with the working environment. So with that working environment only, you can do lot when without any errors. So this was about the setup. So now I just showed two software, that is MicTech and Technique Center. I showed how exactly the how to install MicTech. Here you have to just ensure the path in which particular directory you are going to install your MicTech. You should just know this particular path. So then, so you have to go for Technique Center, and here you have to just do that path configuration. So if you do this path configuration, it will be almost done. And the last this thing is, so you'll be having with the PDF this thing. So giving R20 or R10 or R10 for the viewer option that you will be getting in your build option. Build, define output profile, and viewer option. So here you can just go for viewer, just change this one, so you'll be done with the complete setup of your LaTeX environment. So if you have any doubt in this this thing, means so you can just put in the YouTube chat box, so we can take up that this thing. So now we have covered with why LaTeX and setup of this thing. So next, so we'll be starting with one particular example how exactly you can go and start with the LaTeX. So I'll be coming with a basic editor now. First, I'll be just showing with the tech worker. So next, I'll be showing with the Technique Center. So you can use the same program to compile and edit in both this thing. Tech worker also you can use. Parallelly, you can work on both this thing. But I'll be telling when to use tech worker and when to use your this thing, Technique Center. So because that will be very much helpful whenever you're working. That is, if you want a fast processing of this thing, means so it will be very helpful. So now I'll be doing with my tech workers. So here, before starting tech worker, so just observe the option. You are having a option to create file, that is new template, open recent, save, save as. And all your tech file, by default, it will be saved in the extension called .tx. That is, tech is a markup language which will allow you for go for document markup language option. So .tech, so if you open in tech work, no need to specify the extension, automatically it will take. Next, edit. So you can see you are having some different option, a number of options you are having. Search, same option like what you will be getting in your this thing. So next you are having your formatting, comment option, uncomment option. If you want an indentation, you can check this one. Next, you are having a script option. So as of now, for a beginner, this is not required. So just observe, you can have a look what exactly this one can, how exactly this one can be done. So in meantime, there is one error, like in Windows 7, not possible to install this thing. So in Windows 7 also, same configuration. No need to worry about any this thing. So you will be having the same configuration, same setup, what I showed. You can do the same thing in your Windows 7 also. It doesn't difference for your operating system version. And the second this thing, after understanding this tech work, the main important thing is the build environment. You can see here PDF tech is there, PDF LaTeX is there, Lua LaTeX is there, XLaTeX is there, XLaTeX is there, or you're having LaTeX with n number of options. In fact, if you go for XTeX, you can document your LaTeX in Kannada also. So if possible, tomorrow I will show the title page. I have showed, like I have given an option like in Vishwasara Technological University, like Vishwasara Tantrika Mahavidyalaya. So I have given that one in Kannada also. That one also you can do in LaTeX. So in meantime, there are some question, so which is which need time to this thing. So I will just answer that question at last. So here the version what you have to set is in your TechWorks PDF LaTeX Make Index plus BibTeX version. By default, what and all environment you will be getting. So you have to just set up this environment. So this is with respect to TechWorks. So coming to the Technique Center. So parallelly, I will show the difference and I will show what is the feature also, so that you will be very much comfortable. So here also you can see. So here LaTeX to PDF. So LaTeX to DVI is there. So DVI also is one particular output profile, or LaTeX DVI PDF option is there, or you can see XLaTeX, LU LaTeX. All this thing is appearing because of my MikeTeX package. So here the default is LaTeX to PDF. So you should ensure that LaTeX to PDF will be your build environment, that is output profile. In TechWorker also, you should ensure that PDF LaTeX plus Make Index and BibTeX environment. So this before starting your environment, so you should be knowing this particular options. So now this is my TechMaker. So before starting with our actual program, so I just want to show what and all you can do in LaTeX. So now this is my MS Office. So you might be worrying like what I am doing with MS Office. So what and all options you are having in MS Office: bold, italic, underline, strikeout, superscript, subscript, case sensitive, coloring, alignment, center, justify, bullets, numbering, then with different variations of bullets, indentation, then title cases, then insert cover page, insert blank page, table, pictures, shapes, then insert chart, go for header, footer, page number, then text box. Next, in page layout, you will be having a page size, margins, orientation, all. You might have known this one. So now what and all I have told this one, everything you can configure with just one set of command in your LaTeX. So now let us just begin with the simple example. So you can see in TechWorks. So how to begin any particular option, any particular document in your this thing is, so you have a main this thing preamble, that what you are going to use is document class. This is the initial step what you are going to use, and you have to mention like, so what is the type of document you are doing. So now I will just show with example like article. Article is my type of document. So this is one default step. So this is the main like your main function. So you should have this particular document class article, or different option you are having. So you have to use this one. Apart from that, so the main content will go in begin document. So what and all content you are going to have, like FTP on RM and LaTeX / end document. So I'm just showing with this thing only, and there will be no PDF, and other PPTs material will be provided for this thing. Since it's a hands-on session, it should be you should just look into the what and all I am typing, and you have to understand. So just first is document class article. Article is my I want to do an article. Article features is by default it will come in a A4 size paper, and so it will have some inbuilt option, like your heading will be of font size 12, then normal this thing will be of 12 with regular font, then you will be having figure caption will be of some specific font size. Everything will be predefined in article. So now you can see begin document, FTP on RM and LaTeX I have given. I will just click on this type set, that is run, that is equivalent to build in my technique center. So it is asking me to save in desktop. I will save as my first program. So you can see the right side. So I have a document with just FTP on RM and LaTeX. So I will just zoom out this one. You can see the paper layout, which is of A4 paper layout. So you'll be having A4 paper layout, since article is A4. So you can see A4 paper layout. So, and you can just check the font size, and you can see the page number also. Article, I have not given any page numbers in MS Office or any other. This thing means you have to specify the insert page number. But if you use the option article, means by default, so your article page number has been appeared here. So now I will just add some text, and I will just compile so that you can observe more and more text here in the PDF document. So you can see, so I'm getting all the document. So that is in Technique Center. So you have to open PDF will be open in separate this thing, but here, so parallelly, simultaneously, you can code here and you can view your output in the next screen only. So this is the features of, this is a benefit of TechWork. So when you have to use TechWork means when you are doing any trial and error, and when you are working with piece of information, like small bit component, if you are working like only figure, only picture, or only text, means, so then I recommend you to go for the TechWork. That is the default editor. But when you go for your actual thesis or reporting documentation, so I recommend you to work with Technique Center. So I will just show how to work with Technique Center also, with example of the Technique Center. So now you can see, so all this thing, so it has taken PDF, so it is of A4 size. So now, so you may be worrying, like sometimes I may need documentation with landscape, or I may need a documentation with different page setup. So for that also you have a option. You can set up your page, like how exactly you can set up is, you are having a package called use geometry. So you'll be having a package, use PAC package. And so if you just view geometry, and you have to specify what is the size you want. So I'll be just giving your geometry package. This is for using this geometry, I have to give use package geometry. It's like you were using your header files in C program and any other this thing. So now I need A3 paper. So I'll be just giving the command is, so A3 paper, comma, and if I want in landscape means, so I have to just specify landscape. And so if you want any margin means, so I can specify margin in You can give any this thing measure. You can give in centimeter, or you can give in inches, or you can give in millimeter also. So now let us observe what will be the changes for my document. So just observe this right side of this document. I will just compile, and you can see there is a changes in this one. So now I got a A3 paper, and this one is landscape option. So A3, and it is landscape. So now what I will do, I will just remove this landscape, and I will run again. You can see I got a A3 paper, which is of portrait. Means by default you will be having a portrait option. If you want, you have to override that one using a command. And by default you will be having some margins here. So if I just give, so you can see by default you will be having one inch margin. That is same as word margin. So if you want specific margin, then you have to give the margin here. So to observe that one, so now I will just make this one as A0 paper. So you can see A0 paper, you are not even make out the text here, because A0 means the paper size will be very this thing, and font size will be like 11 or here it is 10 font size means. So it will be difficult to do that one, identify. So you can see this is A3 paper. So now what I will do, I'll just recall into A4. And even you are having one more option called legal paper. So that is one like your MS this thing, you are having an option like legal paper. So you are having one font options, one page setup options. And you can see the margin is so very less. So instead of 5.5 centimeter, I will just make as 5 centimeter. So now you can observe the margin between page and this thing is, so all 5 centimeter means towards top, right, left, bottom, all pages will be having same margin. So this is how you can set up your page if you want your own documentation, means own page setup. So apart from that, you are having one more option, like if you go for geometry, and if you want specific margins. So if you just give A4 paper, next I will be giving total, means the what is the total paper size I'm having. So for I want 170 mm and this is one some set of margins, a paper margin, a paper size in millimeter. And if I want my top margin should be of some 20 mm, and my left margin should be of some 30 mm, I can specify that one. And if my right margin should be of some 10 mm, so I can just specify, and I can compile. You can see here the left margin is more and the right margin is very less. This is 10 mm, this is 20 mm. So and top is 20 mm. So if you want to observe more changes, so I will just make this one as 200 mm. And I will compile. You can see it is somewhere else. So this thing is went away. So I'll just make this one as, instead of 200 mm, so I'll make as 40 mm. So you can see this is my margin, top margin. So if left, similarly, if I give 90 mm, so you can see the margin page setting of your document. So this is how you can set your margin you want your own document. So since most of the time we'll be sticking on to the standard, so this package may not be this option may not be very much required, unless you are customizing your template. So you can just comment this one, comment for commenting here. So you can just go for option the shortcut here. In Technique Center it is Control Q. So here it is little bit lengthy. That is comment, Control Shift J plus this symbol. If you press means all, it will comment, or else you can just give percentage. So I can just mention percentage. That red color indicates that so your session, your particular this line has been commented. And if I run, So I'll be getting back my original this thing. So that is document, which is of type article. So that is article by default, you will be having a A4 size option. So apart from article, you are having some beautiful this thing, tags. So I will just show you are having a title tag. Title, I will give like Friday FDP, and you are having a author tag. I will just give author is be just giving author this thing, and you are having a date option. And if you just run this, options, date, author. So I think a date, I have to specify document class. So you're having a title class. So document article. So after this, so in order to make this, you have to give. So if you miss one, so there will be no error, but it will be not made until you give make title option. So there is one specific thing. So since make most of the time, so we are not going for using this make title option. So it should be, so you can see how exactly there's no difference with the whole this thing, but you're not in the option. So make title should come inside your document. So what and all configuration, what and all you are doing. So the setup, everything will be outside, but make title means this is what actually call your content. So different options, everything it will be called. So that should be within your document. So what and all command you are having, that should be within your document. So this is how you have to just go for troubleshooting. So most of the time, even though if you not get output, so there is a mistake in, that is you have forgotten some command, or there is a misplace of some particular command. So once you, if you give make title, you can see Friday FTP, author, and this thing. And I have not done any font configuration for my Friday FTP. So it is automatically taken, that is given by the article. And you can see the author title and date, everything has been taken by the LaTeX only. So I have not done any particular configurations. So next, similarly, so you can just go for other than article, you are having an option called report. Just if you run this report, so you can see this will be my title page in report. Means like your project report, and my content will be in the new page. So this is the beauty of LaTeX. Like whenever you are doing any option, this is how you have to start with. So you'll be just report if you give means. So you can see this is report one page and this one. So no need to do the cover page separately like what you are doing in other environment. Apart from report, you are having a book. So you'll be just giving a book means. So book also similar to same this thing, but you will be having a page numbers here, you can see, and you will be getting some headers and footers for the book. So this is how you can work with the book particular option. So apart from that, you can include your specific configuration, you can include any individual templates, and even in question I saw like how exactly you can go for Beam. So how exactly Beam, use the Beamer option. So to use that Beamer option, so you can just include that Beamer option also. So now there is one question like they're asking whether geometry or package is a case sensitive. So to do that one, I will just go for title. I will make the title title and I will compare. So I didn't get output, and I will make this as case sensitive, title, uppercase of this thing. I didn't get my output. Yes, LaTeX is a case sensitive, so you have to give all in the lower case. So this is how you can cross verify. You can see here this tick symbol. It is in red symbol means it is still compiling. So you cannot observe any particular this thing PDF whenever you are doing. It is showing the old PDF only, and you have hanged with some errors here. So you can see, so error, it is showing like question mark. It has put some question mark, and it is showing there is a error in slash title. So if I just redo this, stop before this thing, stop abort your type setting, and I will just change the author and I will run. Again, you can see undefined control sequence, and it is showing what is the undefined control sequence, and it's giving the command. It will not tell what is the error. It will not tell like whether you have done you have made it uppercase or it is not case sensitive. It will not throw the specific error, but it will give undefined control sequence error, and it will like give that particular line which is having an error statement. So this is how you have to debug your documentation whenever you are working. So you have to debug is very much required, or else you have to depend on others to get your documentation done. And most of the time, if you're going, when you're doing with thesis and other this thing, it will be very difficult if you're having dependency. So now without any error, so I have run this particular document. So this is working with the tech work. So now the same program, so I will just close all this one. So I'm having my first this thing. I will open in my technique center. You can see there's nothing changed. The code remains same. Only the syntax might have changed. So I will just do this compile and run. So my PDF has been opened. So most of this thing, PDF has been done. And here the technique center, one main thing what you have to do is, so now the PDF what I have opened, if I have not closed this PDF, but still if I go for compiling, so most of sometimes, so I'll be getting an error. So here preferably after viewing your PDF, so close the PDF and then compile or go for any other changes. So don't open the PDF here. I will tell what is the reason for that. So here also I will do some error. I mean, I will just compile. So you can see here, I will be coming to the BibTeX error later. LaTeX results, two errors, one warning. So here you have to just keep on scrolling where is the error, but there is one option, this red color symbol, previous error, next error. So in the control, you are having an option. Just click on the previous error. It will take you to the previous this thing. Missing document begin. It is missing. It's showing one error. Then undefined control sequence. Because this is undefined, all the statement will be become what and all statement next to that your it is following. All will show in command, and it will result an error in the begin document because of one syntax mistake. So you'll be ending up with two errors. So just I'll compile that, do this changes. So now, so I have done with zero errors and zero warnings. So this is how, so you are going to just work in your technique center. So this is all the example of technique centers. So now I'll be just showing since another 15 minutes is there. So as I discussed, so I wanted to show what and all options you are having, like similar to your Word content. So what and all options you will be getting for your documentation. So one such option which you want to use, why I am preferring the technique center is, so I will just show this one technique center. Okay, I'm having some text here. So let the make title will be there. So now what I will do, I want to make some my statement as bold. So the command for doing that one is text bf, and I should type some command. And for making italic, text it, type some command. And for making my another option, text, so if you give, I think, so you can see here, it will show the suggestions here. This is one option, that is auto completion option, which you can use for FAQ documentation. Apart from this, why I am telling to go for doing your documentation in Technique Center is don't want to just type all this command. So you are having a toolbar, efficient toolbar options here. You can see here. So this is a toolbar for emphasis. I will just click this one and I will just give option. So next, for going for the new line, the command is double slash, enter. Next, I want some text which should be in bold. So I will just click on bold, paste option, enter. Next, I want some text which should be in italic. So I'm not typing any commands, but I am getting all the commands here. Next, I want some slanted, click on slanted. Next, I want the typewriter word. Typewriter word. Next, I want the case sensitive, like caps, this thing. So all this thing. So you'll be getting a easiest option in the Technique Center. So that is the features which you will be getting in the Technique Center whenever you are working. So it will be very easy for the beginner to start up. So now I will just run this document and see. Let us observe what are the changes I have got here. So you can see one is emphasis, two italic, one is typewritten character. This is typewritten character, and another one is case sensitive, fully case sensitive. One is bold and another one is fully case, smaller caps. So smaller caps, if you want to find out, means I will just make it I have given in lower case, but with that command LaTeX has converted into upper case. So this is the option, or this is the features which is very much handy in the Technique Center. So it's not like that you cannot do this one in your tech work. So tech work also you can do. So I'll just show in tech work also. So we are going slowly. So since it's our first this thing, so there is no need to make up very much hurrying everything and lose the fundamental concept. So you can see tech work also I'm having a same option. So now what I will do, I will just will comment the make title so that I can observe all the changes here only. So you can see here. So all my PDF, so even though it is lowercase, so you can see it is a uppercase, and you can see all new line character, that is double line. If I delete this one and if I compile, so you can see it is coming in the same line. That is, for getting in new line, you have to give the double slash. So it will enter into this thing. So now you have seen all emphasis, text, italic, slant, this thing, text, this thing, capsing, smaller case, everything. So now let us see some more option, like if I want to print some special characters. So in LaTeX, there are some percentage, like some character like percentage, ampersand symbol, square bracket, then underscore, then dollar, then hash, at. So if you want to use all this statement, means it is a like inbuilt this thing, wildcard character. So you cannot make directly do this one, include this one for your documentation. So now if I just compile this one, you can see I'm getting a number of errors for this one. So error, it has been, so I'll be getting many errors. So for the reason is, in order to use this special character, you have to mask that one using a backslash. So just give backslash, percentage, backslash, ampersand, square bracket. Next, for all the special characters, just add one backslash. So I'm just adding one on backslash, and I'm just running this one. So at backslash also is one special this thing. So it will give an error. I think hash also one special this one. Now you can see here all my special character and percentage symbol, flower bracket, then underscore, dollar, everything I got. And if you want to have the quotes, so for that you have to use the tilde symbol. So that is the tilde symbol which is below the escape. So you can just use the tilde symbol for the quotes, that is single tilde symbol for single quotes, and double tilde symbol for this thing. So you can see single quotes and double quotes, and again you can see the clarity of the quote, what it is printing. So the clarity makes people to go and do documentation in LaTeX. So that is why all most of the researcher, this thing, they will think of going for documentation in LaTeX. So this is about the option, like what and all features you can use apart from other features. Like now, if you want to change the font size, so by default LaTeX font size will come from font size 8. By default you will be having the this option. So for using the font size 8, so you are having a option called tiny. So I'll be just giving like same character. Next you are having a small tag for this thing. Next you are having a normal size font. You are having one command, normal size. Next you are having, for if you want to large, so you are having a option large. Next you are having a larger option, large, that is given by uppercase of your character, large option. Next you are having a huge option. So all compile and run. So you can just observe the different font sizes. This is my tiny, this is next small, this is normal, this is large, this is larger, this is largest, that is huge. So, and automatically the text break will be there if there is a margin, this thing. So you can see this, these are the font sizes that you can work with the LaTeX. So this is all about the font utilization. Now you saw me that I am typing all commands, this thing. So the same thing I will do in Technique Center. So same page I am opening both Technique Centers. So you can see same file I'm working with both, this thing. So to just give the demonstration. So now most of the time you will be like very much way to search all this command. So there is no need to go for separate reference material or other this thing. If you use Technique Center, it is more than enough for getting the basic options. So you can go for format, you can just go for font series, medium. You can see medium series command came. Next, if I go for bold, BF series, that is bold series. Next, if I go for font shapes, if I want vertical, unshape, then if coming to font size, you can see tiny, script size, foot size, that is footnote size, small, normal, large, larger, largest, huge, huger. So all this option, if you just click on this, so you'll get a command. So within this, so you can just type your command and you can type your content and you can work on. So that is why I preferred and I referring you people to go for working with the Technique Center. So you'll be getting all options. So you'll be getting all options very easily. That is without much coding and this thing, you can just work on this one. So this is the easiest option. Whenever you are working for the first time or this thing, means it will be very much handy. So we came across different this thing styles, this thing options for bold, italic, superscript. I didn't show for getting scores any content superscript. So you have to press this character A_B. So you can see if I give A_B, my this thing is, it is coming like superscript, A superscript. Subscript. So if I want superscript, I have to give the cap symbol, A to the this thing caps. So this one, what I will make, I will be giving in a user font. So just I will run this. So you can see A this thing. superscript a to the power of b, this option, all this command is available. And now we got some warnings here, the errors. But even though if you have errors, we get able to see the particular file. So what are those? This thing we'll just check out. Missing dollar inserted. So one specific this thing is whenever you're using some inline this thing. So if you work on dollar, so that is if you give any special characters like a mathematical character or this thing. So if you just give within your dollar symbol means, so then you can directly make that particular without any error. So like you can see zero errors, you will get the same output. So sometimes you can ignore the errors. If your output is correct, you can ignore the error and you can work on. But so if you want to have zero errors means, so you can just make all this thing very specific. So in my thesis, I got nearly 40 to 50 errors for my final documentation also, but the PDF output was correct. So I didn't bother about the error options. So this is one particular options. Next, what are the other options you people you will be using in your documentation is like having if you want to insert any particular images. So for that, the command for inserting any images is I will just show one particular command how exactly you can go and insert that particular option. Example, so this is the command you have to use. First thing is where exactly you want to have your image, like whether it should be center. Then you have to write a code, begin figure, make it centering. Anyone you can use this one or this one. Centering, include graphics. So now if I want to do here, so I just give I have to start with begin all section. I have to start with begin. I'll be starting with figure or table. You can see it is showing the structures. So if I type, so this is the structures you have to follow. So you'll be having begin figure. So where exactly include graphic. So you have to include the main options. So for doing this one, so there is no need to remember all this thing, all this code. So I will just show how it can be made very easy in your documentation. That is using Technique Center. Go for insert, go for pictures. So your bros. So now I'm having one, I think I'll just open what is the LaTeX one. This thing is there, or else I will browse some pictures. I think I'm having one apple here. I will just give caption apple and I will just click on OK. You can see the entire command is ready. No need to type any command or anything, not even one line, including caption. Everything is made ready. And if directly if I run this one, so I'll be getting my PDF. Oh, there is one error and one warning, and I didn't get my PDF because whenever you are using a figure, you should have a packages. That package is called graphic packages for all your graphics. So you should use this graphic packages. Use package graphicx in case sensitive. If you run this one, so now I can open my this thing. You can see. So I got the image which I am going to use. So here, so the image is actually actual size only it has there. So if you want to reduce the size of this image, just give width is equal to 5 centimeter, comma, height. So that is within square bracket if you specify this one. So just run this, just open. So you can see the size has been reduced here. So this is how you can work. Or else you have one more option. You can just make width as 0.75% of your text width. So if you're having any text within your document and you need your image within the format of your text means, So you can see, based on the text only, you will be getting your images. So this is the options. So what you can get in the images option. So here you will be having a number of images option, like you can work with different of this thing images. So like you can work on JPEG, you can work on PNG, you can even work on EPS format, all this thing. So in tomorrow's class, I will just show that particular example. So since we are at the end of this this thing session, so just another 5 minutes, I have one assignment part also to work on for tomorrow's documentation. So this is with respect to image. With respect to tables also, we have to you have some different configuration. We have to check out that one. And try to just to have a table, so you can go for table, some caption, and you can just see table code is ready. Just copy and paste the content. And if you want your bullets and numberings, so enumeration, so this is for bullet. So if I just do this and if I run this particular this thing, my document with bullet will be ready. You can see here bullet options is there, like that numbering options and all is there. So just try for this option. So all a number of options are available. So tomorrow I will just take out with equations, tables, and I'll be sharing with smart diagrams how exactly you can come with algorithm. So all I will be showing. Since we are running shortage of time, today we have to end this one. This is just have a try on this particular this thing. While coming to equation, I have two to three things to share, where most of the people will face very difficulty in doing images. So it will be very hectic whenever you are going for having configuration, you are configuring your images and all. And even one major this thing tomorrow session is, you can see pie chart also without going for Excel. You can have your pie chart, and if you have any smart diagram, so you can just check. Tomorrow I will explain what and all is this. So smart diagrams, like crystal clarity smart diagram is available. Simple, with normal tags, you can generate this one for your LaTeX, and it will add a very attractive this thing for your program. All this thing is for tomorrow's session. And the thing which I wanted to give for us, like assignment, is you can just have a practice installation. You can try. So like how exactly you can go with working with all these options, that installation you can check. If any error tomorrow, if required, we can start the session early also. So I'm ready for that one. So just go for Google Scholar. Those are doing research, and if you have referred some papers, go for Google Scholars. Type some what and all paper you are having, what and all paper you have referred. So just open the Google Scholar. Here you'll be having a site symbol. Click on site symbol, and you'll be getting a big text. So this is text document. So just collect this text document. So at least for 110 document, collect this document. I will just show how exactly you can go for doing the referencing option. How exactly you can check out with that referencing option, I will show in the tomorrow's session. So now, so if any questions, so I'll just we'll try to answer the questions. So kindly please explain in a moderate speed. First page, this and all I will be showing in tomorrow's class. One question from Dr. Syed sir. So that is thesis writing. Since starting only, we cannot go for thesis writing, like how exactly I did my acknowledgement certificate and all. So since we are having all the beginners, so I just wanted to come with a very beginner, like how exactly you can add all packages and then build a project. So now what and all I showed, very fundamental this thing. So tomorrow I will include this everything in the VTU this thing, thesis template or in report template, and I will generate and show how exactly you can generate acknowledgement, how exactly you can generate certificate page. Everything I will show in that tomorrow's class. So directly if you go for this thing, it will be difficult. And tomorrow, hope I will be slowly I will be explaining with my thesis this thing only. And one more question was that is installing missing packages. So as I told, so missing packages one during installation only. So if you just connect your system to internet, so you can identify the package and you have to install dynamically. And Windows 7, someone told that you are getting error. So you can follow the same procedure, same installation you can download, and you can work out with same installation, this thing. I will, if possible, I will be sharing the images in the group. That is installation step, you can follow the same. If any error, you can contact me with the if you are in group 1 and 2. And there's one more error from Victor sir, that is sir, how about using overlays for my point of view, MicTech installation and configuration is confusing. Sir, overlays is an online editor. So being a researcher, when I am doing my own document, that own thesis, I don't trust the online this thing. Since doing all the document in online, it may be not safe. Since we are having a plagiarism issue and all, it will be very complexing. So as of this, my knowledge, I don't refer anyone to do or use online sources for doing the research documentation. And coming to that, you told that installation is very complex. It's hardly a 5 minutes task. Installing TechLive, just click. I'll be sharing the image. So just try the installation once. So if follow the procedure what I given. So after that also, if you're not able to install means, then you can take your call. But I don't refer only for the research documentation. So there is one more this thing. Should I download the basic MicTech for the LaTeX? Yes. So your LaTeX packages. So it will be in either you have to download basic MicTech or you have to download the TechLive. So anyone, it should be there. That is, these are the main source of your tech provider. One more question. How to install Beamer missing file in LaTeX? So Beamer missing file. So whenever you go for like include package, and if you tell Beamer, when you compile this one, during the compilation time only, it will ask for the installation of the missing package. But for that, so you should ensure that is starting only, you should make sure that, so ask every time you have to give that particular option. And if it is connected to internet, so the missing package will be installed automatically. And one more question from Victor sir, that is, is the geometry is a that is case sensitive? Yes, it is a case sensitive. So all LaTeX command is the case sensitive options only. So any other questions? So no other questions.
No, those are the only questions, sir, that we have.
Ma'am, just one more this thing was there. So there was like how to write an algorithm in LaTeX. So yes, tomorrow I'll be just sharing that how to write an algorithm in LaTeX. And one more is like share the images of the installation. Yes, I'll be sharing the image of the installation. And this video is available in YouTube. So you can just I'll be sharing the link of this one. So you can just view the same setup installation. So starting installation and all, it was little bit fast means. So you can just play the video and you can just observe the what and all steps I have explained. I think, Rupashri madam, we are done, I think.
Yeah, thank you so much for the detailed hands-on session, sir.
Very good afternoon to all of you. Really, we had a wonderful session in LaTeX. So, on behalf of all the participants and organizing committee, I extend my heartfelt thanks to Dr. Manju Prasad. Thank you so much, sir, for your effort you have spent to do this hands-on session. Really, it's a very enlightening session and a overall session for us. So you are starting from the installation, you have covered all the basic concepts related to latex. I hope all the participants would have enjoyed this particular concept. We are keenly looking for the tomorrow session from your side. So I request all the participants tomorrow also, you join this particular FTP and make use of this particular session. So once again, on behalf of institution, on behalf of organizing committee, I extend our heartfelt thanks to Dr. Manju Prasad for his excellent delivery on latex for research documentation. Thank you, sir. Thank you to one and all. Thank you to one and all. Thank you very much.